Welcome, dirt racing fans, to the Eldora Speedway for race 18 of the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series. We have five races remaining in the season as the Dirt Series returns to the Big E, the Eldora Speedway. I'm in the booth tonight by Zachary Sterno.
What is poppin'?
Alrighty, Zachary, welcome to the booth. We've got our first heat race lined up here. With Caleb Marinelli on pole, Logan Speed is to his outside. I want to hear your picks for this heat race.
Well, it's hard to say. You know, you've got three championship contenders right there, 1, 2, 3 in heat one. Caleb, obviously, a bit of a fringe there, but he's definitely but a heat win here would definitely put him in contention. You've got Logan Speed there, who's gotten back into the top four. Tanner Campos, obviously, is third, just about 20, 25 points out. But I'm going to go with the highest one in points. I'm going to go with Tanner Campos.
All right, I'm going to have to agree with you on that one. Tanner Campos really needs a good day to, you know, shorten that points gap between himself and Zach Stern and Colin Dover. So he needs to perform in this heat race. I have him winning it. As we'll come to the green flag, Caleb Marinelli leads him to it. Logan Speed with a big jump on the outside.
One thing you got to remember from last time you were here at Eldora, that bottom line is super dominant. And just like that, here comes the 00 Tanner Campos to the point.
Yeah, Tanner Campos right to the lead. And how about Xander Thompson there in third? We haven't heard from him since the Chili Bowl when he almost won the thing.
Xander Thompson can do it. I think he just not cared for the past couple. Oh!
Oh, we got a spin in the back!
Dylan Jones.
Oh, that's going to kill his heat race. He's going to start towards the back of the B main now. As he has Xander Thompson up in second now. Logan Speed on the bottom trying to take that spot away. Chris Black and Caleb Marinelli also in the transfer positions.
Tanner Campos right up against that wall. He carried too much momentum. Here comes the 91.
Yeah, another thing to note here, that wall can jump out and bite you. We saw that at the first race of the season, and it's definitely paying dividends here in the second trip here. And now it's Logan Speed back to the front, Caleb Marinelli on the bottom trying to take the lead away. They're going to go three wide for the lead.
Tanner's getting aggressive. He knows how important this heat win is. And here comes that 15 back to the inside. It's Caleb Marinelli, and they're coming up on the lap traffic.
2x2 for the first two positions of the field. Tanner gets into the wall a little bit. That's going to help Caleb get a noticeable gap on the rest of the field. With Xander Thompson trying to slot into second, Tanner gets into the wall. That's going to cost him the third spot to Logan Speed. And Xander Thompson just making his way around the lap traffic right now.
Caleb is going to come to two laps to go. He's got a pretty comfortable lead. He just has to keep it clean, not make a mistake like that.
Yeah, Caleb got into the wall once again. That's gonna give Logan Speed a big run on the Xander Thompson.
Almost three wide.
They're gonna come to the white flag this time as Caleb.
And Xander Thompson, they go.
Tanner just squeezes by on the side, but he's into the wall.
That's gonna cost them both big time. Here comes Sydney. That's for the transfer spot. Caleb's out. Can he get back in?
See what happens here. I think they were side by side there, and we cut away. I don't know why. But here's Logan Speed, who has claimed his Heat Race 1 victory. We'll get a replay in a little while here. But Logan Speed, nonetheless, winner of this first Heat Race.
The ticker's showing Caleb Marinelli just getting in. We're gonna have to go to replay to sort this one out.
Alright, here's what happened off of turn four. Looks like Xander was either too quick or Caleb kind of got bounced out when he hit the wall. A little bit of both, as you see Tanner all the way up by that wall trying to ensure that Caleb doesn't come back up and hit him.
Tanner just kept his foot in it, trying to get past that 15 as quick as possible. Was kind of nothing he could do. Got lucky that he got away with that.
Yes, we have our spectator cam. Chris Black also getting very close to that 15 Pepsi machine as Sydney comes by and passes both of them on the bottom.
That's going to move Sid into the A main. And now let's see if how Caleb's behind Pop-Tart. He is in the wall!
Yeah, well, now here's the replay of onboard with Caleb. I think that getting in the wall may have cost Xander the transfer spot. Maybe our kicker was correct after all.
We'll see. There's the 56. He's in the transfer spot, trying to get back around Sydney Allen to get that spot. It looks like we're gonna zoom back to the 56.
It was Tanner just squeezing by him, getting into the wall. And then, yeah, he definitely is able to get the throttle back on quicker because he landed himself going forward.
There's Sid. Are we going to get the angle this time? In the wall! Oh!
I think Caleb definitely got him there. Here's the difference. It's about half a car length at the line.
That is tight.
Yeah, a very, very close finish to round out our first heat race. Leads Caleb Marinelli getting that transfer spot. We'll be right back after this brief commercial break. Welcome back, Dirt Racing fans, to the Eldora Speedway. This is our second heat race of the evening with Tyler King on pole, Caden Bishop, Bristol Dirt winner on the outside. Once more, I'd like to hear your pick, Zachary.
Not a lot of title contenders up here. Tyler King trying to get into the top 10 in points, pretty much same as Caleb Marinelli. The guy you got to have your eye on is Colin Dover. That is second in points.
Yeah, Colin Dover definitely looking to take that points in back. Green flag goes into the air. Tyler King leads him onto the back straightaway. Caden Bishop is not willing to give up that easy as they're three wide in the back.
Colin Dover, Caden in the wall. Colin Dover takes fourth.
Colin Dover getting up into that transfer spot as Dontavious Young is going to take second from Caden Bishop, and now Colin Dover is going to move up into third.
This is a big performance by Dontavious. We haven't seen the 18 run like this in a while, but here he is running for
the win. Now he's looking for that heat race lead with Colin Dover right behind him. Tyler gets into the wall. A big slide in the back of the ocean with Brandon Allen. And now it's Colin Dover going for the lead on Dontavious.
This is a big deal. If he gets these 5 bonus points for winning the heat, that puts him in the points lead by 1 point, and that would put a lot of pressure on Zach Stern, who's in the next heat, to perform.
Now here's Tyler King not giving up so easily on Colin Dover. As Colin gets into the wall, Tyler drives away with the lead.
Oof. Now let's see if Colin can run the 69 back down. He's, kind of losing time here, it looks like.
It seems like it's going to depend on who makes those mistakes off turn four for getting in the wall. That's not good. If Tyler King gets in the wall and Colin doesn't, that could very much help us. We'll switch to our spectator cam for a brief moment.
But Colin is losing a ton of ground. Now he's going to lose second.
Yeah, maybe Dontavius is starting to get back on his horse here on down the back straightaway. He's definitely gaining a significant amount of time through three and four.
See Caden there on the bottom making a big charge. He's going to try to go after third now. Oh, in the battle for the lead. Here comes
Dontavius, Tyler King. Side by side as they'll come to the white flag this time with Tyler in the wall. Caden Bishop up to third. Colin Dover is there in fourth, now passing Caden for third.
This is going to be big Tyler King crossover move. Is he going to get him?
I'm gonna try it. Yes, he gets it. Tyler King wins our second heat race. Nothing Dontavius Young could have done off of turn four.
Brandon Allen holds the final transfer spot. Really not much of a battle. That was pretty easy. So we won't see the B-Main the B-Main.
No, sir. Brandon Allen's been very good at avoiding having to bring his skills to the B-Main recently. But either way, Tyler King holds off Dontavius Young for a second heat race win. We'll be right back after this brief commercial break. Back dirt racing fans to the Eldora Speedway for a third heat race, and this is one you definitely like to keep your eye on. Front row teammates and championship title contenders Zach Stern and Carter Jones. So Zachary, I'd like to hear your picks.
Well, this is probably gonna turn into a battle between Stern and Carter Jones for this heat win. Those are the two guys that need it the most. Zach obviously wants it to extend that points lead, and Carter wanted to cut some inroads in that points lead, which is around 25 points to the 62. Let's see which of them can pull it off.
Definitely interesting to see that. Zach Stern took the green flag, and now he's leading the charge down the back straightaway. Carter Jones dropping position after position. He's already back to fourth and into the wall.
Oh, that's tough. And here comes Seth Peters trying to not imitate Martin Truex Jr. on dirt.
Now Seth Peters is going to go ahead and not quite, now he does, clear the 8 of Zach Stern. Zach Mick puts a risky block on the 32 of Paul Bowman, but Paul's still going to try to get that run on the bottom.
That was a big move. That took a lot of nuts, not going to lie. Oh, and he's in the wall. That was pretty dumb. That was small.
That's going to put him side by side with Carter, as now Paul goes ahead and takes the lead away from the 78 of Seth Peters.
Seth Peters now starting to fall back. Oh, Zach, what is he doing?
Zach can't keep smiling, not you. Carter.
Oh, Paul.
Paul did get.
Carter Jones, he's in the wall. Seth's in the wall.
I think
It look side by side. Oh, Carter is in the wall again. Three laps to go.
Seth really took that opportunity and expanded his lead as they head down the back straightaway. There are three laps to go. Now Seth is going to be coming to two. As they both get into the wall, Seth seems to have not as hit it as much. And now it seems like Zach Stern has made his way into third. Something must have happened to Paul Donlan. He lost a lot of ground.
Zach's now going to see if he can get one more spot on the 62. But neither of them are going to get the points. It's going to be white flag. And unless something drastic happens, it looks like Seth Peters is going to come away with the heat win.
And there he is, the 78 of Seth Peters through 3 and 4 off the final corner. Seth Peters wins our 38 race. Carter Jones second, Zach Stern third, Paul Dolan in fourth. And it's Deloney, Benjamin that is, grabbing the fifth and final transfer spot.
That better not have predicted Martin Truex Jr. winning the Bristol Dirt Race, because that would suck.
Suck. Like, who likes Truex? Imagine liking Truex.
Imagine liking him so much you have the same sponsor as him. Like, it's... Like, imagine Zach having Ally. That would be ridiculous.
But I... Welcome back, Dirt Racing Fantasy Eldora Speedway. This is our final heat race of the evening with Kylie Grider on pole, another points contention driver. I would like to hear your picks one final time, Zachary.
Well, I'm obviously not going to pick Demo Redneck because I can't stand one, impact font, and two, forward-facing roof numbers. So, yeah, but yeah, I'm going to go with the girl in the title fight. I'm going to go with Kylie.
Alright, as Kylie's going to lead the field to the green flag, Demo Redneck on the outside, not really getting a big jump off the start. Kyler Scott's going to follow Kylie off into the third turn.
Here comes the 17. Ooh, they all keep it off the wall except Raven for some reason.
Yeah, Raven may have had a little bit of contact with McNelson. Now there's Kylie in the wall. Kyler Scott's going to take the lead. And now another driver who hasn't been relevant since the beginning of the season. It's Gavin Grant. Getting,
Where the hell
getting
did Gavin
place away.
Grant come from? What the hell, man? What the fuck?
Gavin has not been relevant since, like, the very start of the season. And now he's running up here in the top three. With now this Kylie Grider trying to get third, and there's three wide for second.
I know that these heat races are short, but I don't know if I would have made that move.
That was a very, very risky move, but every spot is a huge jump here for the A-Main in the heat races. So I guess Demo knew what he was doing. Maybe not. I don't know. Again, these drivers are literally not learning. But here's Gavin Grant in second.
He's in the wall!
Everyone! Well, not everyone. I saw Gavin get into the wall. Quite a few drivers got into the wall that time. And then here comes Gavin to the bottom on Demo.
Gavin Grant to the bottom of the track. Is he going to lead it? Oh, he takes the lead.
Gavin Grant to the lead. We haven't said that in a while in literally any league he competes in. And now here's Kyler Scott getting third away from Kylie Grider.
He's not won a misc league race since the Southern 500 in the MLNCS. So quite a long drought there for Gavin Grant, I'm sure. This heat win's not going to snap that streak, but I'm sure it'll feel pretty sweet if he can get it. We come to two to go, and Scotty's in the lead.
Yeah, just as you say that, Kyler Scott takes the lead away from Gavin Grant. Kyler Scott won Bridgehampton earlier in the season, but has had bad luck for the rest of it. Kyler's going to come to the white flag this time, as there's a battle for second between Demo Redneck and Gavin Grant.
I wouldn't count out Demo Redneck. He's pretty far back, but if Scotty hits the wall, he has a chance.
Here they come off the floor. Kyler.
Contact! Contact!
Kyler Scott just barely.
Wow.
Very close there. As the ball out of the pit road, a big slide from Kyler Scott. And a little bit of frustration from Demo. He spins
Demo,
him off pit road.
What the hell was that?
Kyler just spins it right back around like a magic, but a little bit of frustration between the two.
Big G hit Nick Nelson for no reason. What the hell?
Yeah, tempers are flaring here. I don't know what happened back there. But yeah, we're going to go to break. Welcome, Dirt Racing fans, to our first main event of the evening. It's the B-Main here. We got to set those final five spots in the main event. It's Xander Thompson on the pole position with Chase George to his outside.
Yeah, this one's pretty easy. There's only one of these cars that showed race-winning speed. Like, I don't mean like B-Main winning speed. I mean like A-Main winning speed. So, just to make it interesting, I'm gonna pick the 36.
Alright, fair enough. As we're gonna come to the green flag, Xander Thompson is your leader here down the back straightaway, and they're already sprinting out and jostling for position as they hit the final two corners.
Oh no, oh, they're four wide. They're four wide, that's not gonna work!
No!
No!
And he's gonna come back to the track, big act on the second lap of this race.
Oh no! Oh no, the lead cars are out! Wait, why am I oh-knowing that?
Yeah, why are you oh-knowing that, Zachary? That's a good thing! Only one of the lead cars escaped that!
I'm sorry! I will never support weebiness, ever!
Alright, you have learned from your mistake, that's good. Looks like Elon Solbrook's car didn't have a fun time there.
God damn it, a weeb car beat Elon Solberg. That's not fun.
It looks like Quinn Yeager with issues as well. That's very unfortunate.
God damn.
Yeah.
So.
But anyway. Yeah, we'll just go ahead and take a look at our leaders right now. It's Xander Thompson in front. Now we'll take a look at a replay. It looks like Baron Poole may have turned the 71 coming off of turn four. Into the inside wall he goes, and I don't think he had time to correct it.
Baron Poole, what the hell was that? It's lap one of a 25-lap B-Main. Get over yourself and give him some room.
Yeah, I have no idea what that was about. Either he did that intentionally or he was stupid. I would say that there's no way a driver could be that stupid, but A, it's Baron Poole. B, these drivers are literally not learning.
Just comes back up the track, no grip, and just takes out the weed cars. I think.
And it was really nothing. Oh, there was a big hit there. Elon Solberg, but again, there's really nothing you can do. Brakes aren't the best here on a dirt surface. And trying to correct yourself on a three wide pack isn't very easy to do. He's on board with Quinn Yeager.
Oh, nowhere to go.
Yeah.
You see, Noah Wetzel just earned my respect by taking out a bunch of weeb cars.
That is something I never think I hear you say, Zachary.
I can't believe I'm saying it either, if I'm being totally honest. To take a look with one of the weeb cars.
Yeah, it's General Jake. He was just pushed along by Raven. For no reason.
What do you... Now there's General Jake, that's beep car number 51.
Alright, fair. And while we welcome you back to our live coverage with the lights on our Dodge Charger pace car going out here. That's one to go on into this caution. The pace car will be in this time. Xander Thompson is still out front with less than 20 to go.
Yeah, the 2020 Dodge Charger is a pretty nice car, but it's not as nice as a Toyota Tacoma, and you should totally go shop at your local Toyota dealer.
Well, you see, here's the issue, Zachary Sterno. That is a 2010 Dodge Charger.
Oh, but what if I wasn't talking about that specific car?
Oh. Big. Okay, green flag anyway. Yeah, no Wetzel's lapped down.
Big brain.
Oh, no.
Big brain.
No.
Anyway, but Brian anyone is doing surprisingly well.
Oh, and Big G exists too, yeah. Here he is inside the top 10 with a huge battle going out in front of him for the transfer spot.
You see, I would question why no one's trying to Justin Newman!
And the Weep car number 51 was involved in another one.
Oh, that stinks. No, it doesn't.
Newman
was involved, not Weep car number 51. That is.
Yeah, I love that Mountain Dew Zero scheme, I will say.
That is crisp.
Mm-hmm. It looks like the other two Weeb cars are doing just fine. Dylan, not so much. As now we'll take a look at our leader, Xander Thompson. A lot has changed up front. Brian Leon now holds the second position with Chase George in third. Giancarlo, you're under there in fourth, and Marco Suarez in fifth.
I am offended that a ski mask with a slump car got odd car is doing well.
It is what it is. Now here's Justin Newman losing it for no reason and taking out the two Eric Jones racing cars in this B main once again.
Justin Newman has become my hero. He took out the weebs.
He did. I'm just unfortunate that he's a backmarker in the series, taking out the weebs from our spectator cam.
But you see, the biggest crime of the Dylan Jones car isn't even that it's a weeb car. It's that it has red numbers on a red base. So we take a look.
Yeah, see that? I can't even see the numbers until, like, we're, 2 feet away from it.
Looks like, yeah, you just lost it. Just,
Yeah. It's all on Justin there.
Just tried to go in way too deep.
Usually you don't see cars running that far down. I guess Justin Newman was kind of forced to as the lights have gone out once again on our Dodge Charger pace car.
Do you think we can get a green flag run all the way through? Because I don't.
I don't either. Honestly, this, all right,
so
this might also be in a chaotic... Yep. This probably also means we're going to have one chaotic main event, too. As he's got two cars locked down, General Jake was able to get back in this one. Noah Wetzel still not on the lead lap.
Come back, green flag.
Damn, Thompson's going to lead into green once again. Brian Leon not losing too much ground there. They were three wide with the lap, and they still are. Look at Mazzilli now getting stuck behind the two.
Oh. Roberto takes it four wide through the middle.
Yeah, that was a big fly out of a 42 of Roberto. Keeps it straight, though, as we'll head back up front. Now it's Chase George. They're three wide for second with Giancarlo Giranda.
And Xander's in the wall. Brian's
in the wall. They're still three wide up there. Big G with the preferred line. Chase George in the middle. Xander tops it up on the high side. Out of turn number four, Xander into the wall, Big G, not quite to the lead, they're still side by side, there's some contact with Mark back.
That is for the transfer spot back there. Can Xander Thompson now get back to the lead on the 90. Yes, pretty
good. And that's, yeah, just what he did. He was able to keep it off the wall. Big G didn't. As now, there's Chase George making his way into the second position. Brian got around Marco for fourth. And now this is, I think this is just outside our transfer spots over here.
Baron Poole trying to get up there, but I don't know if he has enough time. He's got to make up a ton more spots to do it.
Yeah, and also keep it out of the wall, which has proven to be a tough task. Five to go in this B-man.
Right now, Brian Leon is in that last transfer spot.
And then there's a Jacob Wario there, too, is inside. He takes that transfer spot now. Now Giancarlo Urenda is going to drop back to fourth if Jacob Wario can complete the pass. And then there's Roberto Crown in the battle for sixth.
Ooh. Here, does Roberto have enough time to get to Jacob to get that transfer spot? I don't think he does with three to go.
I don't think he has the speed. That's quite a gap there. And Jacob's been able to keep it out of the wall. Oh, that was close.
He might catch Chase George.
Yeah, Chase George hit the wall there. Here's Roberto once again. As now we'll take a look at Xander Thompson, who has a 2-second gap as he'll take the white flag. Jacob Wario looking for third. He just takes it. Now he's looking for second on Giancarlo Urenda. As he'll head down the back straight away. No competition for Xander Thompson as he exits turn number four. He wins the B-Main. The final transfer spot is for Marco Suarez.
Roberto misses. So does Brian Leon, Baron Poole, and Dylan Jones.
The only Eric Jones racing car in the main event is Dontavious Young. Who would have thought?
Damn. Should have thought of that before you fired him.
Yeah. But anyway, our car is going to pull onto the pit lane. We'll be right back for the main event after. Run! Run! Welcome back, Dirt Racing fans, to the Eldora Speedway. This is the main event. The event you folks at home have all been waiting for. The 25 best cars from the races this evening are now here to battle it out to see who will be the overall event winner. Logan Speed is on pole for the main event. Tyler King is right there in second. Let's go trackside for the command. Today's star lineup, Logan Speed, Tyler King make up row one as mentioned. Seth Peters, Tyler Scott in row two, Tanner Campos, and Dontavious Young will round out our first three rows. Zachary, is there anything interesting you'd like to point out about our main event before we go green?
Well, first, that Colin Dover and Zach Stern have a lot of work to do. Logan Speed is one of those championship contenders, and he's going to start this race with the lead. That's not something that they're going to want to see. They're going to want to bridge that gap as quickly as possible. And hopefully someone other than Logan, preferably either Stern or Dover, wins the race.
Now here comes Logan Speed off of turn four, leading them to the green flag for tonight's main event. He gets the jump on the inside line, but Tyler King isn't willing to give up that easily as he'll go 3 wide for second.
Seth Peters looking to make a statement as Tanner now goes to the inside. Tanner, he knows how few races are left. He's not going to give an inch. It looks like a caution's out already.
Yeah. Looks like it involved Big G, Marco Suarez, Chase George, maybe. Chase George may have not even been able to start the race.
That's a tough break for a team that benefiting a ton from this A-main appearance, but just not that not start. I mean, they did a great job just by getting here, but not starting is gonna hurt.
Yeah, Chase hasn't started in A-main since the beginning of the season. Tough break is now Tanner Campos seems to have been able to take the lead when the caution came out. So he'll lead us back to green when that does happen with Logan Speed and Seth Peters right behind him.
Zach is able to get up to eighth as we take a look at what happened.
Yeah, it looks like teammates making contact off of the fourth turn that sent Big G spinning. Nothing else, a very minor spin, just unfortunate for the driver of the 90 Chipotle machine.
Yeah, he lost it trying to stay off his teammate, made a little contact. If you're going to wreck, that's the kind of wreck you would want to have in a dirt race, is a lazy spin. It's enough to bring out a caution so that you can say it doesn't hurt you too much, but it's not enough to severely impact your race.
Yeah, we're getting on board with Giancarlo Urenda here. He definitely had a big slide off of turn four, so he tried to avoid that incident from happening, but it was inevitable given the run that he had off the corner on his teammate. And then on board with Marco Suarez, we watched the whole accident happen in front. Whoa. And now behind.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good driving there by that five to stay off of him in a situation where we've seen so many guys get into it.
All right, a very called for a little cleanup. So now we're going to go back green this time as the lights have gone off on our Dodge Charger pace car, which is now green for some reason. But anyway, Tanner Campos is our leader.
You see, it's one of those. You know how some cars, like for double headers, like they'll have like multiple wraps, and then they'll take a wrap off for the wrap below it.
Yeah,
see, I think that's what the pace car has. I think it had a purple wrap for the B main, and now it has a green wrap for the A main. I don't know what the colors green and purple signify, especially since they're not series colors. But anyway, green flag.
Yeah, we're back green flag.
Logan, right to the quarter panel.
On the back front straightaway, looks like Tanner Campos got into the wall there. He's going to lose a ton of spots as we get a flyby.
Yeah, this field a lot more spaced out and tame than they were last time we went to green. Is Logan in the wall?
Oh, no!
Tanner in the wall, Seth in the wall. Here comes Scotty.
Scotty gets right by him after what could have been a massive pileup onto the front straightaway. Kylie Grider now bridges the top three. As now, very close with Dante. Yes.
These guys are, I don't know how much further they'll make it racing like this. It's Kyler and Kylie for the lead.
As now we'll come to less than 40 to go here, and a little bit of contact between Kyler Scott and Seth Peters off of the corner. We'll take a look at these battles inside the top 10. Now Kylie Grider continues to lead. Here's Demo very close again with Seth Peters.
Seth with a monster save. I don't know how he saved it. Demo's now gonna take the lead from Kylie. Let's see if she can recover. Or Kate Bishop's gonna get underneath her. Oh, Seth again! Somehow he saves it. Look at Zach and Dontavius in the back. They're like, no! Keep us out of this!
See? Or as Zach and Dontavius seem afraid for their lives, and now Kylie has fallen really far off the pace as she's...
Oh, spinner! Seth Peters! And into Kyler Scott!
Kyler!
Caution is out as Justin Ricci's mic appears to be having issues. Logan Speed led him back to the line.
Alright, I returned. Hopefully my mic is better now. But Logan Speed continues to lead the charge here over Tanner Campos, Demo Redneck, and Luke, who's in fourth.
The 8 car. That's what Logan and Tanner don't want to see, is that 8 car starting to... As this race goes on, he's starting to get better and better. That's what they don't want to see, is that 8 car creeping up the scoring pylon. They want to see him mid top 10 as we take a look what happens here.
It looks like Seth had too much speed off of that corner, got it sideways, and then Kyler, an innocent bystander, stuck, I think, 3 wide, had nowhere to go, plowed right into the 78, and then the 75 plows right into Kyler Scott.
Just kind of accordion effect there. Just kind of, once everyone starts slowing down, it's hard to avoid. You see, she's going full speed there, trying to gain spots when they hit the caution, and, when the wreck happens right after the line, tough to avoid.
He's on board with Kyler Scott. Seth spins right in front of him, as he'll go for a spin as well. Zach Stern really capitalized on that. He gained a ton of spots when they spun. Says if he didn't let on the brake pedal at all.
Those are the kind of aggressive moves that are going to win a championship. You can't let something like this, as we see from Kylie. You have to take everything you can and use it to the best of your ability. And that's exactly what this 8 car did.
So we'll go on board with Seth Peters, who had a bit too fast of a run off of the corner and got right into Demo. There's Kyler Scott, and Kyler spinning right behind him. But now we've returned to our live coverage with our Dodge Charger pace car lights going out. We'll restart with a little under 30 laps to go. Logan Speed is the leader. Tanner Campos in second. Demo Redneck third. Zach Stern in fourth. And Caleb Marinelli rounds out the top 5.
It's surprising that we don't see Carter Jones in that top 10. Really would have thought that 62, with how good he's been all season, would be in that fight more. But he's stuck around the edge of the top 15. Really not having a good day.
As we'll come to the green flag here, once again, Logan Speed getting a great jump off of the restart. But Tanner Campos is running a little bit lower on the track. He's going to have a run. So does Demo, and so does Zach Stern on the bottom.
4-1. Contact. Zach Stern backed out. He was like, no, I'm good. But now that they're settled down a bit, he's going to go for the lead.
And right there on the bottom, this might be Marinelli versus Stern v. 367, or whichever one this is. As we take a look at the battles towards the second pack, seems like this top 5, top 6 is broken away from them. As the caution is back out!
Caution, no, Sydney!
Oh, the 90 is completely pancaked in the front end.
That's gonna be a race ender.
Oh, indeed it will be. As he'll pull onto the pit lane, he'll probably disappear here very soon. Yep, there he goes. There's Sydney Allen with damage.
Paul Donlin.
Marco Swords might have gotten a piece of it. Ow.
Real unfortunate, as this puts us under our, I believe, third caution of the A-Main.
We're just past halfway in this main event. Zach Stern leads the charge with Logan Speed right behind them. Caleb Marinelli rounding out the top 3.
Sydney Allen going down the road to repair that car.
Looks like he's coming off of it. Now he's moving back onto the racetrack. Here's a replay. Looks like Paul Dolan thought he was going to get into the 37 and checked up too much. That got him spun around. Here comes Sydney, who had committed to the high line, and Big G!
Oh my god.
That is a lot of air on that 70.
Bro, we got lucky that 70 didn't catch on fire, because that was a hard hit right into the fuel tank.
Surprised there wasn't even any smoke from that accident. He just kept on going. Luckily for
Sidney Allen, what a freaking legend.
He is a legend, but let's also be grateful he didn't have any hot tamales in the back of that car.
Oh, that would have been bad.
That would have been very bad.
You know, I think Big G might have not used the brakes because I think the grill that's in Sidney's car this week is Big G's. Sidney Allen stole Big G's grill.
Oh, I don't even know why he would use a grill for his Chipotle meals.
That is a good question. Maybe he makes Chipotle at home.
Yeah, maybe he steals the recipes illegally. That would be a very no-no thing, but he's Big G, he's cool.
Yeah, maybe that's what he does instead of learning how to do a burnout.
Fair. As now here's Zach Stern, once again, as we're getting ready to take the green, once again. Zach Stern leading the charge with Logan Speed right behind them. Caleb Marinelli, Demo Redneck, Tanner Campos, the pace car takes the hard left on the pit lane. The single file line will snake their way around turn four and come with a green flag once more. Zach with a great restart, but Logan speaking down to the bottom again.
That was a critical must excel restart for Logan Speed, and he's got it. As Sidney Allen's coming back on track, he'll go back down to the garage area. Oh, and it'll all go Zach.
Zach Stern just lost a lot of spots, and it looks like he's going to lose even more with King Bishop and Kylie Grider over there. Now here's Caleb Marinelli going to the lead.
Logan's in the wall.
Second. Tanner Campos gets into the top three. Top three is Marinelli, Redneck, and then Campos. As now Demo Redneck is going to go for the lead on Caleb Marinelli.
That number pointing in the direction that he wants to go. No, Tyler King is in the wall. Where was that? Yeah, that was Tyler King, I think. Tanner to the lead.
Tanner Campos, the leader here in Eldora. There's Kylie Grider battling Demo Redneck for second. And then Caden Bishop also in that battle back there.
Caden Bishop, kind of a big game hunter. He's the two wins he's have been on cable television, the NASCAR Amino Network, as he goes for the lead here on Kylie Grider.
Caden Bishop to the lead. It looks like Tanner's also going to battle Kylie there for second. But Caden Bishop looking for Miss League win number three at Eldora as he seems to have gapped Tanner Campos for a brief moment. But now Campos is back as there's a yellow car pit road.
Oh, that's huge. That is huge. That 62 being on pit road.
He's coming off the pit lane right now. And coming back onto the track. I don't know, was he involved in that caution, or did he have some mechanical troubles? Because there's not much damage on that car. What is he doing?
Carter. What is he doing? Carter, you're not under green. What are you doing?
Yeah, he's just going to slot in line right behind Tyler. Could that be a penalty?
Oh, we saw this from Alan Moot from, this is gonna be tough. It's gonna be curious to see how the officials rule, because if they rule against Carter and give him a penalty, this is gonna turn from a decent to a disastrous points day.
I think Carter, we don't see him there, so I think Carter may have just merged onto the pit lane. So regardless, there really isn't anything to take away from him right now. As we'll take it to caution, very similar to Big G spin, a very minor accident with Trevor Davidson going around on the front stretch.
How did Scotty miss that? Holy crap.
Yeah, Scotty has been getting involved in a lot of the drivers' messes this season. Luckily, narrowly avoids Trevor Davidson, and he's a full speed replay.
Yeah, just kind of gets into the 56 there, and just sort of loses it.
It's just Carter was on pit road before that even happened. So most likely he had some mechanical troubles, or maybe an accident under caution or something, which probably is unlikely because I don't see any damage on the 62.
Either way, that's killer. That team's going to need some help now to win this championship.
Yeah, after this one, there's only going to be four races to go until the finale at Knoxville. The lights go out on the Dodge Charger pace car with 10 to go, so hopefully it'll be for the last time.
You see their
Caden,
name down in ninth, the 35 of Colin Dover has gotten his way into the top 10. Two spots behind Zach Stern. Zach has been in front of him all day, but now it's looking like he's not gonna have that massive points gain on Colin Dover that he thought he would.
as the pace car takes a hard left on the pit road, with 9 laps to go, Caden Bishop leads the field back to the green flag. Tanner Campos there in second, as he's all over the back bumper of the one, and here he comes to the bottom. He'll be side by side down the back straightaway.
Tanner trying to get to the one. It looks like he's going to get there. Is Caden going to get in the wall? He is, and Kylie takes second.
And also looks like Logan Speed's going to take third as well. 8 laps to go in this event. Tanner Campos is pulling away.
Zach Stern trying to get around the 15. Doesn't want Dontavius getting under him as Logan Speed goes for the lead.
Logan Speed back to the front here at Eldora. Demo Redneck's also going to take second from Tanner. As now Demo's also going to be going for the lead here on Logan.
Three wide
Oh,
for third
very
for
close with
Caleb.
Caleb.
Oh, massive moment there. That could have had massive title implications. Luckily, everyone kept it straight, and we're still green.
And now Zach Stern is in third. I can already hear the Jaws music playing, but Tanner Campos is looking to the bottom second.
Tanner trying to go for season win number two. Oh, they're both in the wall. Now look, and now that Jaws music moving towards the climax is starting to second. Caution!
The
Around Kylie Grider.
I think that might have been it. That may have been a huge win for Tanner Campos. That seems to have been the race under caution. A big cloud of smoke up there in turn number four.
We're gonna have to see who is involved in this one.
Yeah, obviously the lights did not go out on the pace car. So, Tanner Campos is most likely going to be the winner of this event unless he has a mechanical breakdown under caution.
Can we just acknowledge how frustrating this must be for Zach Stern? This is the exact scenario that played out in the first dirt race at Eldora for the ADLMS. Coming
Yeah,
up
this is
straight.
the
Take a look at what happened.
Yeah, here's Caden Bishop either getting turned by Caleb or just squeezing him into the wall. There's Caleb spinning. Now here comes Brandon, who committed to the high line, a big impact.
Bad day at the track for Hose Mad.
Except for the double zero of Tanner Campos, who has won this race most likely.
Yeah, but that's a lot of damage.
It is a lot of damage. They only had three cars entered into this event, as we're going to look at another replay. Right to that wall, and now here comes Brandon at full speed. Pow.
Gonna DNF them both. It's gonna give them some pretty terrible outside the top 20 finishes, and that pretty much all but ends Caleb's serious hopes at a title run, at least. I don't he might still be mathematically eligible, but it's gonna be rough to make up the ground now.
Now we'll go on forward with Brandon Allen coming to the high line right into the 15.
Really nothing he could do. Scotty didn't give him a lot of room to avoid it.
And there's the onboard with Caleb. Here comes Brandon. Boom.
Yeah.
As now, here is Tanner Campos on the white flag lap of this race. The pace car is going to lead him around, but Tanner Campos is going to lead the field off of turn number four. A win that may re-solidify his title hopes. Tanner Campos wins it at Eldora.
Big win for Tanner Campos. That's going to gain him a ton of points on the eight. Cut that points gap down to around 15. Definitely a big day for Tanner. Not so big days for Logan and Colin Dover. They're going to lose a bunch of points, as well as Carter and Caleb.
Yeah. Carter especially, finishing 20th, being the last car to actually finish the race. But here comes Tanner Campos trying to celebrate. Remember when you heard last time, Ray Bodega had a tough time and just resorted to doing burnouts on the asphalt pit road. We'll see if Tanner can do better this time.
They're starting to figure it out, I think, or at least hopefully. That would suck if they weren't.
Here's Tanner. Can't get it spinning. It might just be the racetrack. I don't know. Tanner having a ton of issues.
Damn, what do they put on the surface that no one can get a burnout going?
Is it the fact that the front straightaway is banked? Because if that's the case, then I don't know, Caden had a pretty good burnout at Bristol, and that had a pretty steep front stretch banking. What's Tanner doing now?
Is he just going to go straight to victory lane? That's kind of lame.
Like without a burnout. Oh, no! Oh, no! What a unique celebration! He's still driving it, but what a unique celebration.
You know what? Style points, Tanner. Style points.
Style points or Tanner Campos as he loses control trying to get on the pit road. Gonna do a quick spin turn. Oh, let's see. Is he gonna pull it into victory lane this time? He's not slowing down though.
Oh,
round two.
Into the catch fence. Oh.
Car still somehow.
Yeah, that car is junk, Tanner. I don't think you should try it a third time because you might actually die.
He may have heard you because it seems like he's finally going to be pulling into pit road. But Tanner Campos, your winner here at the Eldora Speedway. A special thanks to Zachary Sterno for joining me into the booth for today's race. Let's take a look at today's starting... Today's finishing results.